each school should have to, what happened? The school should have to get up and go up and show your projects to the teachers.
Sleeping on floor or sleeping on mattress?
The student and his wife take a break and clean the rest of the window and some vegetables still remain because it contains moderate CSO.
All my machines do by PC and now I don't call it for software. So simultaneously recording the observations and then I made a graph of it. And then I completed that.
Dust particles PM less than 0.01 micrometer, and after these harmful gases are passing through converted tube, which consists of three sections. First section consists of nano.
What's in my mind? What affects PM? Groundwater or treated water? Can you guess? What affects PM?
American University at Arik. Our chief guest, Mr. E.Y. Nagesh Kumar, FIE, Member Secretary, Telangana State Council of Science and Technology, Government of Telangana State. Our guest of honor, Professor Moin Ansari Sahab, Chairman, Board of Nutrition, America. Our guest of honor, Mrs. Sumaira Sareb Rasool Khan, Director, Shadan Group of Institutions on the Dice School. Mrs. Sumaira Sareb Rasool Khan. Students and teachers. The aim of starting Science Fair Academy was to inculcate the temperament of understanding science in school-going children. Basically, unless until we understand the subject, we will not be able to use that subject, and then you are going to grow and become a best human being, for which the seeds have to be sown only when you are small, at the school level only. The research activity usually in our times we have started only after our post-graduation. Till then we did not know about research or anything that is required what the students are doing in the school level right now. Most of the students who have come from the poorest of the poor background do not have the facility to understand science at all. The language of science is only the experimentation. And to understand this process, Hazi Siraj Azhar Saab has started the science fair in the year 2005, Science Fair Academy, Hyderabad chapter, with the CSR newspaper, with the guidance of Zahid Ali Khan Saab and Zahir Ali Khan Saab. And later on, now Amir Ali Khan Saab is taking care of this one. And we have been doing the science fair activities since 2007 by taking lot of schools from Charminar area and Muslim dominated areas where the students do not have the exposure of good scientific education. Nowadays, the proper good education is only to the elite society is able to get the proper education, whereas the poorest of the poor are not able to get proper education and the exposure also. So we have started taking the poor background localities and the schools from those areas, and then to bring those children into the mainstream and make them a better citizen of our country. And in this regard, we have started training the teachers, and in turn the teachers were able to make the students understand the subject and then come up with the project that we are able to see. It took us almost 12 years for us to come to this stage. It's not an overnight process, and it took us. If you see, most of the students have come from the lower middle class background, and now they are able to question, and they are able to ask how, why, and what. And with this questioning only, the student will be able to learn better. And now, after so many years, we are able to have such a good platform where we have almost more than 400 projects have been selected, and out of these 400 projects, in this today's program, we were able to give opportunity to best of 400, that is, we were able to select 200 projects, and out of these 200 projects, we have taken in three groups, and in each group we are able to give three prizes, and altogether 27 prizes will be given to the students. And I would like to congratulate all the students and all the teachers who have participated, because you are all the winners, because you have taken the first step to be part of this program. You are able to ask why, how, and what, and this is the beginning, and hope tomorrow you are going to be the best of the scientists. You will be able to do better work, and whatever the shortcomings that you have had today, now you understand that whatever the little problems that you have encountered, this you can be able to rectify in the next science fair, or go beyond today's program or today's achievement. And I can, if out of this 200 projects, if at least 2 to 5 students are able to make the difference, and you are going to make the difference to the world. And I want at least few of you to be the best scientists of the world tomorrow. And this beginning has been made. And I would like to thank all the people who are part of the science fair, all the students, all the teachers, and all the scientists, and whoever are with us. And I would like to thank everybody for their efforts, for their enthusiasm, and for making a difference to the small efforts that we have started. And I hope tomorrow some of these students will be able to participate in the international level. And I wish all of them good luck, and hope God bless everybody, and be healthy, be happy. Thank you. was heartening to see that there were so many good projects today. The students were doing their wonderful work and they had done it in a short span of time. And most of our judges who had remarked us was that in most of them they were not having the sufficient data, and they did it in a very short span of time because students were not knowing. Most of the students told the judges that we got the notice in a very short time, so that's how was our preparation. So dear students, teachers and the school leaders who all are present here, I'd like to tell you that our next inter-school science fair, regional science fair, will be in the month of October. So kindly start preparing right from now. And there is a small message from Dr. Khazi Siraj Azhar for all the dignitaries and the students. I'd like you all to hear to him. So will all the students sit silently for some time? Students, please, dear teachers, monitor them. The students were running, make them sit in one place.
Assalamu alaikum. This is Dr. Khazi Azhar from
Vice Chancellor, American University at RSA UAE, and the Chairperson, AMSSOI, Council of Science and Technology, Government of Telangana State. Our science page, who is always willing, ever ready to encourage our students. Thank you, sir, for your presence. Our guest of honor, the youngest one, Mrs. Sumaira Sarab Rasool Khan, Director, Sharon Group of Institutions, who is ever ready to help our students and science day. Ali Masbati Sahab, and helping out our children and encouraging them. Thank you so much, sir. On the animal life was the best represented by few of the students, and there were a few more very good projects. There were projects on lycopene. There were
respected president of the day, Janab Amir Liha Sahab, chief guest, Mr. Engineer Nagesh Kumar, member secretary Telangana State, guests of honor, Professor Moin Ansari, Mrs. Sumaira Sarif Rasool Khan, and Ali Masrati Sahab, dignitaries of the dais, management, teachers, parents, and my dear students. Assalamu alaikum and a very good evening. It's really a matter of pleasure and satisfaction for me to be here today to view various projects exhibited by young students. I think more than the students, the teachers and the people behind the scene who have taken the initiative to inculcate the scientific temperament in the minds of the young students is very important and they must be appreciated. Mujhe sare projects dekhne ka mauka nahi mila, but whatever I could see, they are really remarkable. Dekhe, koi bhi scientific idea overnight nahi banta hai. It takes very long time, sometimes several years. Aaj jo idea aapke dimag mein ek crazy thought jaisa lagta hai, wahi idea kuch saalon ke baad insaanon ke liye itna useful ban jata hai ke bina uske aap zindagi guzarna mushkil samajhte hain. There are several instances of this type. Mujhe yaad hai jab hum log America mein gaadi chalate the aur itni barf गिरी होती थी कि अगर कभी आप रास्ते से भटक जाएं, मेन रोड से हट जाएं, रात का वक्त है, अंधेरा है, बर्फ मुसलसल गिर रही है, मुमकिन नहीं है कि गाड़ी को कहीं रोककर किसी से पूछें. कोई मोबाइल फोन उस जमाने में नहीं था. मैं पुरानी बात नहीं कर रहा हूं, 1995-97 की बात कर रहा हूं. कोई मोबाइल फोन नहीं था, कोई जीएसपी नहीं था, कोई नेटवर्क नहीं था, तो हम लोगों के दिमाग में एक क्रेजी आइडिया आया करता था कि मोटर कार के डैशबोर्ड पर कोई ना कोई ऐसी चीज होनी चाहिए कि जिसको बटन दबाने से पता चले कि इस वक्त हम है कहाँ और हमको जाना कहाँ है, तो रास्ता खुद ब खुद बता दे। जैसे मैंने बताया कि रात इतनी अंधेरी होती थी कि आपको डर लगता था कि आप मोटर से उतर नहीं सकते, बर्फ इतनी गिरी हुई है कि नामुमकिन है कि आप अपना पैर गाड़ी से बाहर निकालें, लेकिन घर तक जाना है, ऑफिस जाना है, रास्ता भटके हुए हैं। जो क्रेजी आइडिया समझा जाता था 95-97 में, आज वो रियलिटी बना हुआ है कि हर एक आदमी के डैशबोर्ड पर जीपीएस सिस्टम इस तरीके से लगा है, कैसे लगता है कि बगैर उसके आप घर के बाहर नहीं निकल सकते। इफ यू अगेन लुक बैक हाउ आइंस्टीन, एडिसन, दोज ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट हैव गिव द आइडिया कि साइंटिफिक डेवलपमेंट होता कैसे। आइंस्टीन का वाकया अभी भी किताबों में पढ़ाया जाता है, उसके दिमाग में एक ही थॉट था कि जब मुर्गी अंडे पर बैठकर गर्मी देकर बच्चा पैदा कर सकती है, अगर मैं भी अंडे पर बैठ जाऊं तो क्यों नहीं अंडे से बच्चा निकल सकता है। उस वक्त लोग हंसते थे, लेकिन वक्त ने बताया कि ऐसा हो सकता है। एडिसन ने जब कहा कि मैं चाहता हूं कि दुनिया को पूरी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी की रोशनी से रोशन कर दूं, पीपल इज टू लाफ एट द टाइम कि ये पागल हो गया है, कैसे मुमकिन है कि इंसान इतनी रोशनी बनाए कि रात दिन में तब्दील हो जाए। आज हमारे लिए मामूली सी बात हो गई कि चलते फिरते गांव के अंदर, गली के अंदर भी हम उसको मुनव्वर किए हुए हैं। द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज के आपके माइंड में आपको आइडिया आना चाहिए। आइडिया सही है या गलत है बहुत बात की बात है वो, लेकिन द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज के एटलीस्ट यू मस्ट गेट द आइडिया हाउ टू स्टार्ट माई साइंटिफिक वर्क और रिसर्च थॉट। मैं आपका मूड बदलने के लिए खुद हमारे जमाने की मिसाल सुनाऊंगा। जब हम लोग पीएचडी कर रहे थे, लोगों को नहीं मालूम कि रिसर्च क्या होती है। अक्सर सवाल उठता है हमारे दरमियान कि आखिर रिसर्च होती क्या है। डेफिनेशन देना मुश्किल है जब तक कि आप खुद रिसर्च नहीं करते। तो मिसाल के तौर पर समझाया जाता था कि एक आदमी ने एक मेंढक खरीदा और उसको उसने ट्रेन किया फ्रॉगी जंप, जैसे वो कहता था फ्रॉगी जंप, तो मेंढक एक मकाम से दूसरे मकाम पर जंप करता था। सुबह शाम उसने कई दिन तक उसको इस तरीके से ट्रेन किया, जैसे वो कहता था फ्रॉगी जंप, वो जंप करता था। उसने क्या किया, उस मेंढक का एक पैर काट दिया, उसके बाद बोला फ्रॉगी जंप, तो जंप नहीं कर पाता था, मगर यहां से यहां बजाय दूर तक जंप करने के वो नजदीक तक जंप कर रहा था, क्योंकि उसका एक पैर कटा हुआ था। उसने क्या किया, उस फ्रॉग का दूसरा पैर भी काट दिया। अब उसके बाद कहा फ्रॉगी जंप, तो जंप भी नहीं कर पा रहा था क्योंकि उसके पैर थे ही नहीं। तब उसने बताया कि उसकी रिसर्च क्या है, उसका रिजल्ट क्या है। उसने कहा कि जब मेंढक का एक पैर काट दिया जाता है तो सुनने की एबिलिटी कम हो जाती है, और अगर मेंढक के दोनों पैर काट दिए जाएं तो वो सुनना बिल्कुल बंद कर देता है। ये जोक की शक्ल में मैंने आपको एग्जाम्पल दी है कि किस तरीके से साइंटिफिक आइडिया गलत नहीं हो सकता है, मगर एनालिसिस गलत हो सकती है, और वक्त के साथ ही पता चलता है कि हमने कितनी गलती की है और कितने गलतियां करने के बाद सही चीज तक पहुंचे हैं। आज की दुनिया में जितने भी डेवलपमेंट्स हुए हैं वो कई गलत रास्तों से होकर सही पॉइंट तक पहुंचे। कोलेस्ट्रॉल की बीमारी इस वक्त बहुत आम हो चुकी है। जिस आदमी ने सबसे पहले कोलेस्ट्रॉल का फॉर्मूला दिया था उसको इतना बड़ा आदमी समझा गया था कि नोबेल प्राइज दिया गया था। उसके दो साल के बाद दूसरे आदमी ने उसको प्रूफ करके बताया कि जो फॉर्मूला दिया गया था वो गलत है, और अब जो फॉर्मूला मैंने दिया है वो सही है, उसको भी नोबेल प्राइज दिया गया। दैट इज द पॉइंट दैट व्हाट आई वांट टू कन्वे, इट्स नॉट दैट के हाउ क्रेजी आइडिया यू हैव, द पॉइंट इज यू मस्ट हैव एन आइडिया एंड ओनली विद टाइम यू कैन प्रूव एंड जस्टिफाई कि आपके पास कितना अच्छा आइडिया और थॉट है जिसको आप कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं। मैंने 3-4-5 प्रोजेक्ट जरूर देखे हैं, वो चिकन के ऊपर मोबाइल फोन का इफेक्ट क्या होता है। लड़की ने बताया, किसी स्टूडेंट ने, कि मुसलसिल 10 दिनों तक अगर आप उसको हर 3 घंटे के फासले से 40 मिनट तक मोबाइल फोन के करीब रखोगे तो उसका वो मर सकती है, उसने बताया भी कि ये एक है जिसको हमने मोबाइल फोन की घंटी नहीं सुनाई, ये एक वो चुकी नहीं जिसको हम मुसलसिल 10 दिनों तक रोजाना हर 3 घंटे के फासले से 40 मिनट हम सुना रहे थे और वो मर गई। इसी तरीके से बहुत से क्रेजी आइडिया होता है कि इतने ऊंचे ऊंचे दरख्त हैं आपको नहीं मालूम कि जड़ से लेकर ऊपर के पत्ते तक पानी जाता कैसे है, बड़े बड़े लोगों को नहीं मालूम। ये चीजें प्राइमरी क्लास में पढ़ाई जाती हैं, लेकिन यही एग्जाम्पल अगर लड़के को स्टूडेंट को फिफ्थ क्लास के सेवन्थ क्लास के प्रैक्टिकली करके बता दें तो उसको इतनी दिलचस्पी आ सकती है कि वो इस आइडिया के बेसिस के ऊपर खुद अपना आइडिया बना सकता है। विदाउट टेकिंग मच ऑफ योर टाइम बिकॉज देयर आर इनफ गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर विद अस दिस इवनिंग, आई रियली अप्रिशिएट एंड थैंक्स अ लॉट टू द मैनेजमेंट, टू द साइंस फेयर एकेडमी, that they have taken such an initiative and encourage the teachers, encourage the parents to inculcate such habits among the students so that they can continue their thought process in the field of science and research. Thanks a lot.
Ashwini, this is Ashwini madam, Department of HOD, Department of Zoology, Tapasya Junior College. Dr. Mehjabi Salma, Pathology Department.
Guest, our chief guest. Our Khan sir, and guest of honor, Dr. Sakotele Mehjabaru. And first, sir, point, I'm sorry. The madam is summarized by the Sulagongi and all other dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, teachers, parents, and my dear students. Good afternoon to all. Good afternoon. I hope you will have participated enthusiastically in your program and you are eagerly waiting for results. If so, yeah, I know. Remembering me of my childhood days, during 1970, I too participated in my district science fair in Nalgonda. My project was selected for a state event. My project is on, if you put a 10 by 10 MP coin, then you will get a chocolate. That was my project during 1970 when I was in 9th, 10th standard. I got this idea because when you put the coin in railway station there, you will get the weight of the person, isn't it? Then I should always think about that machine. What is inside there in the machine? How you are getting that weight? So and I consulted my mama, that was a mechanical engineer. He told me the inside mechanism. Then I got an idea. I took one magnet and one plate, and with the help of battery and other things, I did my project. So thank you to all. And our department, Telangana State Council of Science and Technology, for the information of the members here and the teachers, we are waiting a little bit for the promotion of science and technology in the state for the benefit of students, teachers, academicians and general public and women. It was established in 1985 with the help of Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and the recommendations of Planning Commission, the then Planning Commission. And we are also doing lot of programs and science population activities, organizing National Science Days and National Mathematics Days and National Children Science Congress. It is one of the prestigious programs that we are doing since long, more than a decade. This is a DST PET program. Have you heard about the National Children Science Congress? Anybody has participated in the Children Science Congress? This year, I am happy to announce that so this year, two students have received two national awards out of 15 projects selected nationwide, selected among nearly 700 projects from all over the country. The two students are girl students. One is from JPH High School, Karimnagar, and another one is a girl from Devanar Blind School from Hyderabad, partially blind. She did her project also to come into the mainstream of science. So that is a very prestigious program. Please participate in next year. Every year we'll organize. The students will showcase their projects, the innovative projects, on the focus theme announced by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, from time to time. So every 2 years, they will announce the focal theme. So last year, it was on climate change, and this year, science and technology and sustainability. So here I have seen some projects are very good, and I request all the teachers, there are a lot of hidden talent in the students. So please bring out the talent and make the students the industry ready. I think all the students also to take science and research in their career. Everybody will tell research and invention. Why is research required? Why is research required? Why should we invent? Yes, students here? Yeah? To solve our problems for benefit of society, isn't it? And why these problems? So right from the morning we'll get up from the bed until we sleep, we are facing many problems. So for example, is the pollution. Water pollution, air pollution, everything. The reason is, though we are exhausting all the natural resources, resulting natural imbalance, causing global warming, climate change, etc. So you have to think for new alternatives. So you always think. One day your thought leads to an action, and the action produces some results, isn't it? If the result reaches to a common man, then the society will benefit. So you have to always think, and you have to invent many things, because India has required the scientists. We are very happy that today India is in top list. 103 satellites we are launching at a time in near future by ISRO. So I request all the students here to take up the science in their career. I appreciate and I congratulate the Science Fair Academy and the organizers for their efforts in organizing such type of programs. Such type of program definitely will create interest and boost the children to take up the research. Madam, as you have approached me at the last moment, I could not promise any finance assistance, but in future years cost will come forward to organize such programs. And also you have taken some finance assistance during 2008 exchange. And also thank the host institutions, because they have come forward for organizing next year also. So I thank everybody for giving this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Farid Dutin, sir, of Crescent High School. Pat Jaha, Crescent High School, Divanjodi, Lodi, Saita Musa. May I now request Shaukat Sahab to give away the prizes to Ankur Makur Onisa of Neurology.
A big round of applause for the winners and congratulations to all of them.
Ampul Fatima ma'am informed that there is a lovely program here. So we thought whatever we can contribute a little bit for you all. Thank you very much.
To all the students, parents and the teachers, I hope you all are excited for the results, right? Still physical science result is there. Jawab uska jawab. Yeah, Jamal, you buy all the time of Alamad bullshit. Very good. We both have the same kind of synchronized thinking. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, yeah. Now listen all of you, all the students and the teachers. The science fair was based on the scientific methodology to inculcate the scientific temper among the students. Of MS Creative School. Yeah. Lean Vada from MS Creative gets the third prize in sub junior category. Tarannum Fatima of MS Creative gets the first prize in junior. Aisha Nazim of Mount Masi. That is the first prize. Second. For physical science category. Thank you much, sir. Thank you, sir, for encouraging the children. Of Madina Public School gets the third prize in physical science category. Mother has also got a national prize in Chennai also. Give a big round of applause for our staff. Sidra Adeep of Mesco Grade High School gets. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, Sumaira. We must put this up to give away this certificate. To got a wrong certificate. Durga, please come and collect your correct certificate. Please go. Rukhaya, baby. Okay, yes. Give it to her. Yes. Rukhaya, baby. Okay, yes. Give it to her. Yes.
Good evening, everybody. Shaukat Sahab, Mohin Ansari Sahab, Javed Sahab, Ali Maskati Sahab, Sumaira Sahib Rasul Khan Sahab. First, I would like to congratulate the team of NFSA who have been working with this, organizing this event. They had been to Chennai, got some awards, and with that inspiration, I think they have organized this event. Apart from that, thank you very much for the hospitality here with the school. I would like to thank the management, staff and students of Crescent School, Crescent High School. And since I have to say the vote of thanks, but I would like to say that a teacher is very important. Everybody here on the dais has spoken about your future. But I think the onus and the responsibility goes to the teachers as well. Because a teacher in her lifespan, she teaches 1 lakh students. If you take, for instance, 400 students a year into 20 or 30 years, maybe 40 years she puts in her effort. And it's an entirely ongoing process. So teachers deserve a round of applause. And I think the students here who have participated in the science fair, I think you people need to take this as a serious working thought process. It should go on like a thought process and try to get what you can do, how you can solve the problems. We have told about the what's, about the questions, 4 questions like that. Whatever the project you people think of, I think you should have what is the basic necessity and how is it going to be useful. Like for instance, I have just seen a pollution project, then a papaya tree project, then the radiation effects on human psychology, human beings or any living thing for instance. I think with that, what comes to your mind, what is the next step you will be delivering, what is the problems you are facing. In Old City, I think we are all facing a lot of problems, whether it is Old City or Torichoki area, Mount Masi School or New Rosary School, we are having a lot of problems. Try to solve those problems and using a scientific way. So in that way you will be utilizing your services, your problems can be solved through you people. So this is what I wanted to say, and I would like to thank the Crescent High School management and all of you here for participating in this and making this a grand success. Thank you very much.
Science Fair Academy, from printing banners, certificate, getting the medal.
For more updates, subscribe to our channel. Keep the show links. Enjoy watching videos.